Watch as now you're sitting on the machine and just not even moving, totally balancing it in a non-moving position. That is the very, very first thing that a Hollywood stunt double will learn. This machine is specially designed for balance, and is worth over $25,000 to a Hollywood stuntman. Look at that for balance and coordination. This particular machine is designed in such a way that it can climb up a steep, rocky mountain peak, up to a 70-degree bank as it goes up, almost up a mountainside. You've seen Hollywood stuntmen in many motion pictures using these particular motorcycles as they go rough riding or trail riding. These machines will go way, way beyond what your normal trail riding machine will do. Watch closely as Donnie's got the machine balanced and you see two automobiles lined up in front of her in a little demonstration of what we call trail riding. Watch as he takes that machine all the way up and over the tops of those jump automobiles out there. Right up see the fiery, flaming board wall in the middle, ramped to ground, up and over the top, and back there in flames. You see the flames coming up on his arms, off his head, off his back. Believe me, it's hot. The cameras would stop now. He goes off camera into a safety area, and the firemen put him out, and is he all right? Yeah, he's all right. From Bangor, Maine, meet the crash man, Jim Moreau.
Got your head and shoulders tied up down by the chimney yonder. Where do you keep your rear end at? Right up behind the microphone. Hey, wait a minute, Clutch. Now you know the cardinal rule in the outdoor performances.
Drop it!
For our next event, you see a ramp structure has been constructed in the middle of the arena. You see one of our young stuntmen, Mr. John Anderson, laid out in the middle of the arena. You see Pat Jackson behind the wheel of the number 21, 4,200 pounds of Dodge Dakota pickup truck. There are no supports underneath this board at all. It's merely a 6-foot long board. The stuntman has the board set firmly in place. There are certain pressure points that exist in the human body, and the board has been placed precisely on those points. This is a stunt of geometry, balance, skill, and weight distribution. We don't recommend you try it on your own. This particular stunt was first performed for a motion picture called Stagecoach in 1938. We recreated in the raceway now with no tricky camera angles. Nothing whatsoever. We ask for complete silence in the middle of the arena. Up one, up two, and none the worse for wear, Mr. John Anderson.
All right, gentlemen.
Awesome.
sitting 13 feet 10 inches in the air, hydraulically steered. It has over 90. It's loud and it's obnoxious. It's called the Beech Nut. You see the cars in the middle of the arena. It's time for Beech Nut Chewing Tobacco. Look at those rust pushed down in those cars.
Thank you. Kitties chew tobacco. Would you like to try a free sample of beets not chewing tobacco? Now this flavor is moist and balanced. It has balanced taste and everything. Oh, and it tastes delicious, especially with little tights. Like the wintergreen? Oh, real good.
Ringside seats for this afternoon's wrestling. Onside seats.
They don't tell me he don't work.
Hey, you're on candid camera there, buddy.
God, don't get the camera wet, Pete!
Ready to go. Don't show this to everybody.
My teeth out.
Yeah.
Forget it.
ATF. sure I will.
Wrong way.
No reason.
10 minutes.
Approach in New York has lined up that gigantic Pinstop Monster beat down here this evening. And he's going to line it up right there and take it on those old automobiles as soon as he's set and ready. The beach, not beach. What else, Bud Snyder's come pounding down on there tonight?
Elevation out there tonight? Well, normally you don't see that ramp elevation. It's hidden by a piece of machinery. Upon a young lady to take her place behind the wheel of that automobile, Lori Dolan. She comes to me all the way from Belle Fountain, Ohio. And young Lori is one of our crash experts. Of course, Lori has appeared many, many, many times on television and in motion pictures as a double for Kate Jackson, one to be exact here. And she's got that beautiful blonde hair out there tonight. From our superintendent crew out here this evening, young Lori Nolan from Belle Fountain, Ohio. and should be returning out of that very dark and pit area, headlong and head first towards this loftier ramp elevation tonight. And we're going to see just what Lori can do here. This evening. Now the opposite takes this automobile. Up.
She takes it over the top of the turn, heading for that ramp elevation. She takes it off and overhead. And she said it just the way it's supposed to be done. And she's in that automobile. We're going to wait till she gets out of that tonight is to see if she's okay as the BeachNet safety team quickly races over. There she is from Belfont, Ohio. What do you say to Lori Dolan? Yes, sir. That young lady really knows how to demolish automobiles, but I'll tell you, she does a lot of them. That's about probably the 500th car that she totally destroyed out here this year. I'm sure. Lori's fame and a lot of credit for major television and motion pictures shows. So remember, Lori, L-O-R-I, Dolan, D-O-L-Y-N, when you look for the movie credits under the stunt work for some upcoming pictures. But right now, we're going to be calling upon those to do. Take that automobile up. All four tires exactly the way it's supposed to be done. But right now, John Anderson's going to be attempting a different stunt for us here tonight. This is called an uncontrolled roll. Signed a couple of years ago. Let's watch him now as he takes it on a ramp elevation. And a smashing, crashing. The fleet emergency ramp up truck with the push bar in the front is there. And we're going to wait for trackside to see if John's okay as he's in that completely demolished automobile.
It's on the back of the seat of that Yami. He pulls it up, maintaining the balance. Way down to the deck with the turn. And for the on the back of that motorcycle, maintaining the balance right in front of the grandstand. That doesn't work right. Who do we have out here today? Identify yourself, sir.
Captain Cookie!
Captain Cookie! Well, welcome to the Dock County Fair, sir. I see you have your leather strap, and your leather helmet, and your goggles. You look set and ready, sir. You're into leather and chains, I hear. Never mind. Okay, well, anyway. Get that thing out of the way. Kickstart it, get it out of here. Yep. Wait a minute, sir. No. I don't think you understand. Your trusty steed this afternoon has to be choked first. No. You have to choke the engine. And then, yes. And then you jump start it. What are you doing? Jump starting. Did you lose something that ordeal?
Oh, that was fun.
That was fun, yes, we know it. So we can tell by the expression on your face. Okay, so now that you've choked it, you've kick-started it, what are you doing? No, it's a trusty steed, but it has an engine. And with a mighty roar, that 1.5 horsepower Crimson Stratton engine, he thunders into the turn! Cookie, wait a minute. I don't think you understand. What do you think you are? The space shuttle Columbia?
Yeah, where'd
we
go?
Oh, rockets away, bombs away. Wait a minute. Get that thing down.
Okay.
You tried to kickstart it. You've choked it. You've jump-started it. And it still isn't running. What left is there to do to it?
Got to fire.
Fire it up then.
Yeah, fire!
No. I mean, start it. He's got it. He's fired. He's ready. He pauses with anticipation, and there he goes, off to the wild blue yard, with a mighty roar that 1.5 horsepower Crimson Stratton engine, Cookie thunders into the turn. We've got Donnie Bennett on the racetrack, and Donnie, if you're set and ready, let's go. Donnie Bennett from Austin, Texas,
Now, ladies and gentlemen,
Nancy Riding, running with one foot and one hand, two wheels over, with no hands, no feet, and he does a push-up to boot. Sitting ahead, and one foot extended out that way. Woo! Done.
Lying down yet.
Look at that. Lying down a motorcycle, extending that 6'4" body in that prone position. He's up all standing on the seat. With no hands. That's a nice round of applause for Downey as he takes it down here. Ooh. And a motorcycle backwards here this afternoon. When he brings it in for a quick 13. Ooh. Let's welcome to Austin, Texas, Mr. Donnie Brenneman. Donnie Brenneman, motorcycle rider. As we get ready for flame and fire, and speaking of flame and fire,
a raging inferno of fire as young John Anderson Jr. awaits the top of the turn. The flames stand in a minute as the flames leap high. Our motorcycle rider takes it up.
That purchased your souvenir program, if you look on the back cover, you'll see an artist rendering of this billboard ad. And this is exactly the way the country saw it as they drove down our nation's highways. This afternoon, Donnie's going to be reconstructing the same stunt for you here this afternoon as he takes that stock production Dodge Dakota Beechnut truck over the higher, loftier ramp elevations as we're preparing for high skis, aerial wingovers, or in plain layman's terms, the ability to drive and balance a vehicle on two wheels.
Right past the first point, he's cutting it in, he's gonna kiss the lady on the fence with the dodge. Move back, sweetheart. There he is. And Donnie Brenneman will be stepping from the vehicle of that truck, and we know that one more time now. Oh, Donnie said he's gonna give it one more shot out here today. One more time, he's gonna see maybe he can go just a little bit farther down there, maybe to the third or fourth telephone pole here this afternoon. You've been such a wonderful audience here at your Dark County Fair here this afternoon, and the track's in pretty good shape. It was great shape when we started, but we kind of dug it up here, got a lot of ruts out there. So Donnie has to be aware of the ruts and the rough spots on the racetrack that we have created with our vehicles here this afternoon. Here comes Donnie, one up and away, hanging out there, maintaining the balance on two wheels. Ah, look at him go. The only driver can drive. Wait a minute, what's he doing? Looks like he's driving that truck about 35, 40 miles an hour out there this afternoon on two wheels. Man, not only is he the only driver that has mastered the art of driving a pickup truck, but the only driver that drives driver high while hanging on the top of that pickup truck, and he's out here this afternoon. It looks like a package of Beechnut chewing tobacco going around this racetrack on two wheels, and Donnie Brenneman is driving that truck about 35 to 40, 45 miles an hour. Now, too bad we didn't have the photo finish here with the clock going on them like you do on the harness racing, but our young Donnie Brenneman is the master out there of mechanical movability. Donnie Brenneman from Austin, Texas, it looks like he's going to take that truck to the halfway point. Yeah, he can hear you out there, Donnie Brenneman. Yes, sir, he's halfway around this half mile level out here this afternoon. I'm telling you, if that Dodge works that well for Donnie on two wheels, think tire wet of that truck out there, but our driver's tired because he's hanging from the top of that pickup truck as the back end is fishtailing all over here this afternoon. Donnie Brenneman, it looks like he's going to make that truck the full and complete circumference of your racetrack here this afternoon, but it looks like Donnie's slowing down. He's going slower. He's taking it slower. All the way to a dead stop, and he balances it on two wheels. Right there. We're going to bring it in the park. Watch him very carefully. Don't make a purpose. Look at that. What is that?
At the tower, and young Jim Iding, guarding the belt safety helmet, and a pair of power and speed out here this afternoon. Here he comes. They got me with you, Jim. I need a board at the green light all directions. And our stuntman is safely through on that one. Let's have a nice round of applause for Jim Iding. Jim Iding from Chicago, Illinois.
Your vehicle, all you see is what the camera sees when the automobile comes towards you, and all of a sudden it's flipping down the racetrack. We've got two types of rolls we're going to be exhibiting here this afternoon. The objects to take it on the ramp, roll it over, and land it on all four tires. Not many more, not any less. And that's just what he's doing today. Lands it on all four the way it's supposed to be done. Let's have a nice round of applause for Jim Morrell from Bangor, Maine. Jim Morrell from Bangor, Maine. And that car is still running. What are you going to do, Jim? You going to try it again?
His sound of that engine. He took it on the ramp elevation. He rolled it over and landed on all four tires. That's exactly the way it's supposed to be done.
Well, Johnny right now, how is to roll? We got a big one out here this afternoon. So we're going to wait as he goes all the way back into turn number two to measure the distance that he will need here this afternoon. John Anderson Jr. from Decatur, Indiana. Here we come down to the top of the turn now. Steady as she goes, John. As he lines it on the ramp elevation, we got a smashing. Out there this afternoon. Now the Beechnut safety team quickly races over to see if John is A-okay. All right, we're going to wait for a signal from trackside to let us know that he is okay out there this afternoon. As they pull him from the wreckage, Jim. There he is, none of us words from where. What do you say to Johnny Anderson from Decatur, Indiana, our uncontrolled crash expert out here today. Just a racer. You can see that aluminum case structure there. But we're going to take you back to Hollywood once again. And many times you folks have seen, let's take Platoon. How many of you folks have seen Platoon out there, the movie?
Devil Derby night. Yep, tonight they're going to be doing a big Devil Derby.
and to families around the country and the nation at major state and county fairs. And Pat, this afternoon, will be donning that Bell safety helmet, and she'll be taking that truck to the top of the racetrack. And a reminder that if you choose, we have BeachNut still in the grandstand. The BeachNut samplers are out there, Lori and Julius. And if you choose, we have BeachNut for you. Softer and moister, balanced and better. It's America's choice. It's America's number one chewing tobacco. We have it in regular or in winter green. So raise your hand and you can have a quality sample of BeachNut chewing tobacco. Well, the BeachNut truck's ready. Pat looks like she's set and ready. So fire it up. And ladies and gentlemen, let's send her off in a nice round of applause here this afternoon. Pat Jackson, as she takes the BeachNut truck to the top of the racetrack. And again, when Pat returns,
powerful engine, bringing her closer and closer to the ragged edge of insurgency. With Lady Luck on one side, the Grim Reaper on the other, we're now prepared for an avalanche of automotive fury, a crescendo of crashing steel as she takes it in the air.
Yeah! On the racetrack of the rare car, let's welcome back Miss Pat Jackson. Pat Jackson in a wild flight through space here this afternoon in the beautiful BeachNut truck. And I'll tell you, Pat does a wonderful job in that stunt indeed. All right, now, speaking of BeachNut, we've got the BeachNut in the infield area. She'll crawl from one up into the top of that 13 and lady who has tamed the beast out here, and she's going to be doing a number on it today. And you know, as we said earlier in the show, we had a lot of old automobiles here that we've been using for smashing and crashing purposes. And all those cars were furnished by Trunt Auto Parts. They're the folks that supplied all these old cars for smashing and crashing purposes. And of course, we really want to thank them.
where you desperately are.
Got it upside down. This guy goes yes. Good. Running his head upside down.
Come on, I knew you'd do this.
Here this afternoon, attempting crossovers on two wheels here today. And Peter goes low, Donnie goes high.
Go, Peter right behind.
Closer, gentlemen, easy does it as they take them nose to nose. What do you say to Donnie Brennan and Peter Gross that they can hear you now? Donnie Brennan and Peter Gross, the Dallas High Ski Art.
She moves all the way up. And now, with every turn of that powerful engine here this afternoon, she backs up to measure the distance that she will need here today. Her hands begin to sweat, her heart begins to throb, as this is the moment of truth here. She must go over the training and skill on the line, on the wire. Because she must listen to the sound of the engine, because her eyes are not going to be on the speedometer, but on the takeoff combination. As with every turn of that powerful engine, takes her closer and closer to the wagon edge of uncertainty. Put the interlock on one side, the grip rope on the other. Turn off the tail, turn out a bunch of automobile.
From Las Vegas, Nevada,
and has controlled Roll out here this evening. And we can definitely say that he completely demolished that old automobile out here tonight. Right now, John shows you how to do a controlled roll to take that automobile, land it on all four. Now we're going to be coming.
It's got to get Dallin's picture. It's him birthday. Bring Dallin out.
The Musketeers.
Charter's down the clouds.
Shut up, Pete.
Stuck with
Pete,
Pete,
the camera's on.
Second, that's the Charter.
He was stuck with
Donnie showed me how to, what did we do last night?
He squeezed the Charmin.
Sniff and squeeze the Charmin in the grocery store. Well,
I was holding it like this.
And I was squeezing it like this. And Donnie says, no, you don't do it that way. You gotta take your finger and you go pop. And then you squeeze it together. That's right.
Sherman?
Not sucking Sherman, squeezing Charmin. There's a difference. You're disgusting.
He raised his eyebrows though when he finally got a real sniff of it. He'd always just squeeze it and never sniff.
That pot a while.
Johnny just got up. John McGee from Wattsburg, Pennsylvania.
Look, John. Look, John. Look at the camera, John. Look, John.
Champion over here. Continental Championship Wrestling.
Okay,
Rich. Touch your car. Marty Fricker's got the camera going.
Can I get a piece of chicken?
Get your finger out of your nose. Disgusting.
I like a piece of chicken.
You got a piece right there.
You're disgusting, Pat. Right. No manners.
All right, excellent.
Grass is in those beans.
I'm glad I sleep in the trailer, not the bunkhouse.
I guess.
Well, rain.
Big pot.
Uh-oh.
Pete, you want a root?
Two.
Pat is finishing the preheat and stuff. I can say it.
Oh, no.
Hey,
Sue!
I'm rolling in. Woo! I'm going to hear a little bit.
Hey, you doing there, TV lad?
TV lad. Need a close-up.
Oh, God.
Just a Harold.
I'm going to have to show
Harold
my mother this tape.
Harold.
My friends.
We'll close the lens, Harold.
Close the lens?
Yeah, close-up.
Oh!
High volume sales.
Jim Irwin, now you know what I'm going through in the summertime.
What are you guys doing?
You guys? That sounds like bushy.
Take a look at those.
Hey, Petey! Hey, now, Petey! You bring me a chair?
Yeah.
What?
Oh, get away from me.
Yeah, there's chicken and steak.
Woo!
Harold, want to see the house?
Oh, no. Fruit cake.
Mom.
Get over here.
if I'm in Chi Chi's, they're called.
I ain't Italian. I don't know how to say it.
If you go to Chi Chi's, they're called Chi Chi's.
Where's Harold?
Luke. He's sick. He's sick. Chicken.
Chicken man. Bawk, 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 bawk.
Lane egg, Harold.
What? In what?
Lane egg.
In Harold, or he picks the same captain.
Yeah, Harold Captain Chicken.
Pat, I hope none of my friends ever see this.
Hey, Captain Chicken, I'm eating your brother.
Oh. Well, make lawn chairs, Charlie.
Bro,
can you bring over the lawn chairs?
Yep.
Well, I wish I had a free.
Oh, you want a chop.
Pop it and it stays.
The double for John Schneider and the television series The Dukes of Hazzard. Welcome, if you will, 19-year-old Johnny Anderson. Johnny Anderson from Decatur, Indiana, out here tonight. And I don't know where he got that thing he's wearing on his head. But anyway, out of the top of the turn now, she is the number one female stunt driver in America today. She comes to us all the way from Ashland, Kentucky. Welcome, if you will, 26-year-old Miss Beth Jackson! And Beth's got her Donald Duck hat on out there tonight. Yeah, this is for all you kids in the grandstand. Well, Pat backs away and still they move onto the top of the racetrack now. This next gentleman is a 35-year veteran. He comes to us from the great state of Pennsylvania, all the way from his capital. Look at this. Eric, I can't believe they're wearing these things tonight. Peter Gross, ladies and gentlemen. You know, this is a joke on, yeah, but you know, we normally don't wear these hood apparatuses. I have no idea what this next guy's gonna be wearing. He comes to us from Columbus, Ohio. Look at this. Jim Walsh. Yeah, with a bag over his head. Okay, tonight's joke night on me. Yeah. Better looking than he really is. I don't even want to look at this guy. He comes to us all the way from Austin, Texas, and the fastest rising stunt in America today. 6'4", Mr. Donnie Brenneman. Do I dare look? Yeah, okay. Okay, is everybody done? You okay, Donnie?
Yeah.
Hey, isn't he good looking when he takes that mask off, girls?
Yeah.
Yeah, hey, Donnie, got lots of friends up here in the grandstand. Yeah, he's single, girls. Single, 34, single, never been married. Yes, sir, and he's looking for a date tonight, so I just wanted to tell you that. Okay, you done now, Donnie?
Yes.
Yeah, but you're all set, right?
Something loose in
that truck. Is it the driver?
Oh, it's something.
Oh, so something really loose. Oh, okay, what could it be? Oh, no. Cookie's here, yeah. Here's Cookie, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the Alabama State Fair, Cookie. We're so glad that you can make this evening show. You look like Captain Chicken out there.
Yeah.
Yeah, we must have sold that to Crash, huh?
Yeah, whack, whack, whack.
What are you, chicken or a duck? Yeah, whatever.
Picture of somebody in there laying over the hood.
Kept the front end.
You backed your ramp trailer
no,
under
no.
it.
Right no, 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 just tail.
Piggy tail it. Fasten it down. So your front is up, but your back wheels are still down.
Oh, just up here.
See, broke the mirror. How are you going to see where you're going now?
It's gonna look good. This looks like Sanford and Son leaving now.